Life hack, cut a banana with a knife instead of just peeling it like a regular person.
What is up with these life hack videos, dude? All of them are just the most pointless things that make the task you're trying to accomplish more difficult. Whatever happened to just peeling a banana? Now we're literally slicing the peel off of banana, dirtying a utensil, wasting banana, and taking more time than if we just peeled it regular. These life hacks have gone too far. What's going on, Modertrodes? It's your boy Long Nail, back again with another new video. And in today's video, we're going over the hot posts from r/cringetopia. Let's get into it. Oh, what do you know? Another absolutely useless and completely pointless life hack. Except this one, they are using zip ties to make a mug instead of just using an actual mug. Or better yet, drinking the Coke out of the can that it's in. This is the most pointless life hack I think I've probably ever seen. Like, you really don't have any mugs in your house? All right, fine. How about this is a cold beverage? Why don't you just pick it up with your hand? You don't even need the handle. This is, again, completely pointless. Don't ask me why I'm silent, because if I speak, then I will speak only about black holes, time travel, quantum physics, etc. And then everyone else will remain silent. See, here's where you're wrong, buddy. They're not remaining silent. They're no longer in the room with you, because when you give off this much arrogance, it's completely annoying, and nobody cares how much you know about black holes, time travel, and quantum physics. Now, if you just wanted to have a regular conversation with them, and this stuff came up, instead of trying to flex your intellectual superiority, then maybe they would hear you out and have an interesting conversation with you about a topic you enjoy and they might otherwise be interested in. But when you're just this arrogant, nobody wants to be around you.
I want to star in a Netflix series. Twitter, do your thing.
What are we supposed to do? This is where she expects all of you guys to bombard whoever creates Netflix series and get her to star in one, even though she has absolutely no talent whatsoever. And, you know, she asked, so she has to. Otherwise, it's unfair to her. You guys realize there's skill behind acting and being in a Netflix series. It's not just, oh, I asked, so I get to be in one. And the fact that you have to ask Twitter to get you in one tells me you don't have the social following to make up for bad acting, and you don't have the acting skills. So basically what you're saying is, even if you did get put in a Netflix series, it would be one that nobody would watch because the casting was so terrible that it stars you. Introducing the carpeted shower floor. Okay, I've seen carpeted kitchens, carpeted bathrooms. This has to be the dumbest thing possible. A carpeted shower floor? What? I mean, this is just gonna smell like straight mold all of the time. There's no way this is real. Somebody had to have Photoshopped the already awful carpet on the bathroom floor that probably smells like urine and sweaty feet and just a whole bunch of nonsense onto the shower floor. I refuse to believe that somebody is that dumb that they would actually put a carpet on a shower floor. I mean, could you explain to me what this accomplishes? It's more grippy. All right, they make stuff for that. That's made for showers, not carpets. This literally is just gonna soak up water, create so much mold and mildew, it's gonna smell awful. Your feet are gonna be more dirty when you come out than when you went in. What is going on here? My crush, I use Reddit. Me, prove it. What's 69? Nice. What do you think of Fortnite?
I play Minecraft. She's a Redditor, boys.
Oh gosh, I mean, I make Reddit videos, but this Reddit stuff is just so weird and cringy. It's way over the top, and it's like a Reddit superiority complex. Just because you're on Reddit and you like certain things doesn't make you better than somebody who's on TikTok that likes other things, or somebody that's on TikTok and even likes the same things as you. Like, the Redditor superiority complex is very real. I get it doesn't represent a majority of the Reddit users. Like, I'm sure most of you guys definitely aren't like this. But there's probably a couple of you that are and really feel like this. And to that, I say, why? Why do you feel like you're better just because your social media of choice is Reddit and not TikTok or Facebook or Instagram or YouTube? Where does the Reddit superiority complex come from? Because to me, it's just another social media that has plenty of smart people, but also plenty of dumb people. So could somebody in the comments please explain to me why Reddit has such a superiority complex? Or again, certain parts of Reddit? Oh, wow. No one can handle my music. Oh, okay. Again, the superiority complex because you like something that somebody else doesn't like. I don't get this because you know why? I could put on, let's say, rap music and you would have the same reaction as them listening to Slipknot. It's the same thing. But do I go around prancing and parading and going, oh, I'm so much better than these people because I like rap and they like rock or they like country? No, I just go, oh, it's cool. We like different kinds of music. And I'm sure there's some music we enjoy. So when we get in the car, let's put on the music that we both mutually enjoy and be happy with it. But at no point do I think has anybody that's sincerely a friend with somebody and also normal gone, oh, this is just the dumbest thing you could possibly listen to. My music's so much better. Music is completely subjective. There is no fact-based logic behind, oh, my music's so much better. So the fact that people actually get a superiority complex over music is so dumb. This chick who followed a guy running and tried to justify it in the comments by saying he liked it, that he obviously wanted it, and that it's fine when it happens to men. No, if it's not fine when it happens to women, it's not fine when it happens to men. This dude was probably feeling wildly uncomfortable given the fact that this lady drove back and forth to him like 5 separate times yelling, I need a boyfriend, give me a boyfriend, while recording this dude looking like an absolute lunatic, literally following this man around. Could you imagine if the roles were reversed? Like, I shouldn't even have to say that, but clearly it would be extremely unacceptable, and it's still extremely unacceptable in this situation. There's a big, big difference from shooting your shot and trying to spit game to somebody and literally following them around, bothering them for, I don't know, however long this video was, 20 minutes. Like, it's so ridiculous. Let this man run in peace and leave him be, because he's probably equally as uncomfortable as a chick would be in that same situation. It's just so weird, so cringy, probably actually against the law, so maybe don't do it. Hey, I'ma call you when I leave Chick-fil-A. But it's Sunday. Yeah, I'ma just focus on me. Yeah, I'm sure this is a scripted post, but yeah, it's pretty cringe to say the least. I mean, Chick-fil-A, you gotta start opening on Sundays. I can't tell you the number of times I've been like, oh, you know what? I just worked out. I could definitely use a good chicken sandwich right now. And I drive, 10 minutes before I realize, oh, they're not open. And then I have to sacrifice for like a mediocre chicken sandwich from McDonald's. It's just not the same. Chick-fil-A, get it together, man. I'm sorry. I can't. I can't draw. I can't do anything. My boyfriend just passed days ago from the VEED, and I just found out. I can't do anything. I never even got to say goodbye. Dang, that sucks. Post feet. Yeah, that's definitely going to give you the outcome you want there, bud. I'm sure of it. I mean, come on, how inconsiderate could you be of another person's feelings and think it's okay? There's one thing of liking interesting things, to say the least, but then trying to take advantage of somebody when they're in an emotional state and just disregarding how they feel and what they're going through and expecting, oh, well, that's how I'm going to get feet, is so ridiculous and just straight up rude. I mean, come on, dude, do better than this. Proud plant parent. Ugh, what is that? That doesn't even look edible. I mean, literally looks like somebody weed whacked and put that on top of spaghetti that actually looks kind of moldy and disgusting. on its own. I mean, what is this? Can somebody please tell me what this is? I've never seen anything like this ever. And by the looks of it, I'm going to say I probably wouldn't try eating it either. But I don't know. For all I know, this could be some decadent, great meal. So I won't judge too harshly, but yeah, I am judging. But I'll keep an open mind. If somebody can tell me what it is in the comments, maybe somehow I'll try it. But I doubt it. This looks disgusting. All right, Mutterchodes, that's it for the hot post from r/cringetopia. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. And of course, share this video with your friends. And if you want to help support the channel for free, anytime you have any shopping to do on Amazon, just click the link in the description down below. Do your shopping as regular. It won't cost you anything extra. And it'll help support the channel. So I'd really appreciate it. Till next time. Peace.